These people thought enslaving Thorian creepers and Rachni was a good idea. I'll be in engineering.
Don't forget to introduce yourself to Edie, the ship's new artificial intelligence.
Huh. Not a word. Huh. Interesting. Very interesting. Gonna do another crew update.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the FTL. This allows lag-free communication even when you operate off the comm grid.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
Alright, let's do our upgrades. Yeah, let me do the upgrades first. Then I'll mess with that. So assault rifle damage. Yeah. Plenty of iridium for that. 4 out of 5. And heavy pistol damage, 4 out of 5. Prototypes. Oh, you know what? I think we're gonna keep Slam, actually. Can I just quit out? Can I? I already have Slam. You know, and I'm walking into light, and I'm like, it's gonna burn away my shields.
Still need to get to Tujanka, Shepard. My students being held by Bloodpack.
I'll talk to you later, Morden.
We'll be here if you need me.
Oh no! Let's save. Thank you. I hate that. Did Jacob has anything to say?
I hope we can clear up what's going on with the Gernsback, Commander. Doubt my father's alive after all this time. Was there anything else? Just eager to get going.
Opinion of the crew. I wonder if he'll say anything about Tali.
What do you think of the state of the crew?
Yeah. Unless all distractions are removed, loyalty to the mission will suffer. Run this team through hell, and all we're getting is burned. Anything else, Commander?
Yeah, nothing else.
I'm more interested in just talking for a bit.
Already? I'm not big on forcing these talks, Shepard. Let's do this later.
We'll talk later.
Commander.
Check it. Let's go talk to Joker. See if he has anything new to say.
It's great to see Tali on board, Commander, just like old times. It is her, right? I mean, because with the mask, it's... Ah, never mind.
It's her.
That's it for now.
Oh, wait.
See you, Commander.
I wanted to ask. Turn around again.
Commander.
I assume everything's going well up here?
Good for now. Fractured my thumb on the mute, but I think I made my point.
That's it for now.
He said that before. See ya. I sound so thrilled. Let's go talk to Kelly. She'd probably tell me that Tali wants to talk to me.
I had a wonderful chat with your friend Tali. She's not what I expected from her psych report. I like her.
Aw, can you imagine saying that? She's not my friend. She's okay. I do too.
Tali's a good friend. We've been through a lot together.
Corians are so fascinating to me, but they also make me a little sad.
How so?
Why do they make you sad?
Their environment suits are so beautiful, but with their immune systems, they're trapped inside. I wonder what they look like under those helmets, or what their skin feels like under those suits.
Huh. You want to feel their skin, huh?
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Anything else, Commander?
That wasn't asking how the crew is.
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
I better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk later.
Sorry, just coughing and
Commander,
stuff.
You've received a new message at your private terminal.
You told me that already. I got two, actually. From Admiralty Board, Migrant Fleet. Commander Shepard, per Tali Zora Vasnima's request, included with her data delivery from Haystrom, the Admiralty Board has approved her transfer to your command. She has been informed that additional duties to the Migrant Fleet may still be necessary on occasion, but has been given extended leeway to determine when her mission with you is considered complete. The choice was hers, but your role as de facto captain during her pilgrimage may have caused her to be more susceptible to your requests. The Admiralty Board trusts that you will treat your new crew member with the respect due an honored member of the fleet. Should any harm come to her due to negligence on your part, this board will take severe and appropriate action. Admiral Ray Zora, Migrant Fleet Admiralty Board, I do not take kindly to threats. Update on the kid from Captain Bailey, CSEC. Hey, Shepard, just wanted to let you know that the Drell kid's doing okay. Good. Everything's taken care of legally, and he's doing some work for me, helping me deal with some trash in the wards, maybe make life better for some of the kids like Mouse. Not perfect, but then what is? For those who don't know, this is referring to Thane Krios' son. Don't know if your Drell and mine are talking. I told him life was too short not to, but I don't know if it took. Good luck out there, Bailey. Yeah, they actually are speaking somewhat. Now, if we had failed the mission, that message would never have been there. Obviously. Glad I fixed that. She's gonna be in engineering, she says. Let's check the crew quarters. Oh, let's check the cabin. A few fishies. Still alive. Yay! Good. Right, see a tally. Cool. Should be really home there. Start down here. Assume he has anything new to say.
There you are.
I sure am.
My heart goes out to Miranda and her sister. That's a rough situation.
I love the way she talks. I don't know. Something about it.
It must have been really hard for Samara to ask you to help kill her own daughter. She told me she really appreciated your help. As hardcore as she is, I'm not sure she could have done it without you.
Yep.
I'm glad to hear Thane and his son are back in touch. It'll be hard, but I think they'll be fine.
Yeah, I think so too.
Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about.
Sure, more to talk about. Just the way she enunciates, Speaking of Thane Krios.
Do you need something?
You mind if I ask you a few questions?
Not at all.
There's something else I'd like to talk about.
Ask.
Have a few minutes to talk?
If you wish.
The last time we talked, you started speaking about a past event as if you were watching it.
Oh yeah, his Drell memories.
Have perfect memories. We can relive any moment in our lives with perfect clarity. It's difficult to control at times. Some of us disappear into... let's call it solipsism.
Solipsism? What is that?
What do you mean, solipsism?
When a memory feels as real as life, it's as valid as life. Thinking about a moment brings back the smell of cut grass, the warmth of another's hand on yours,
the taste of another's tongue in your mouth. Ooh. Wouldn't you rather lose yourself in such a memory than spend the night alone, staring at walls and metal and plastic?
What about bad memories?
Isn't there a risk that you could lose yourself in bad memories as well?
Of course. Remembering the times I've taken bullets is unpleasant.
Huh.
But I can look at my knee and see it's not shattered. The memories that are hard to escape are those of despair.
You can remember everything that happened in your life?
Nearly. I expect if we remembered the birth trauma, we'd never recover from it.
Huh. Yeah, really. So, do you remember every hit you've, been contracted out to do?
You can relive every assassination you've ever made?
In perfect detail. Every mistake I made. Every target's last breath.
You alright with that?
You don't seem to feel guilty.
Why should I? My employers killed them. My body was only the tool they used.
Yeah.
If you kill a man with your gun, do you hold the gun responsible?
My gun doesn't have free will.
My gun can't decide right from wrong. You clearly do.
My soul does. But my body is merely flesh. Flesh whose reflexes were honed to kill. Drell minds are different from humans. We see our body as a vessel, and accept that it is not always under our control.
Hmm. Huh. It is weird. I'm not sure which one to say. That's convenient.
So if I shot you dead right now, a Drell court wouldn't convict me?
You'd be guilty because you chose to shoot me. If my reflexes caused me to draw and fire when I saw your gun come up, I would be innocent. Humans often believe in a soul distinct from the body. A spirit responsible for moral reasoning that lives on after the body's death.
True.
It's just a bit more literal.
Hmm. So that memory you had before...
The last time we talked, you remembered one of your assassinations. Something about sunset-colored eyes?
That time. Laser dot trembles on the skull. Spice on the spring wind. Sunset eyes, defiant in the scope. A bystander noticed my spotting laser and threw herself between me and the target. She couldn't see me, but she stared me down.
So what happened?
Did you take the shot?
Not that day.
So that was a unique experience?
It was odd that you just blurted that out. Just another vivid Drell memory?
No. She was a vivid person.
A vivid person?
The last time we talked, you remembered one of your assassinations.
That time. Laser got trembles. A bystander noticed my spotting laser and threw herself between me and the target.
So that's it.
She couldn't see me, but she stared me down.
I should get back to my duties.
Shepard, I appreciate these chats we have.
So here's a romance option type thing here. I wouldn't say it's just business. Definitely don't want to choose this. Your species is interesting. I hope this isn't crossing some kind of line.
Haven't had a chance to speak to a Drell before. It's been fascinating.
I doubt many humans have. There are only a few hundred thousand of us left after all. I won't keep you.
Okay. Let's check up on anyone else. Eavesdrop over here. They don't say anything anymore. They must have used up all their stuff. Their, conversation. Let's talk.
Shepard.
I wanted to check in.
I am always happy to talk with you.
Have we talked about this before? Tell me about Justicars.
I'm interested in hearing more about Asari Justicars.
We hold a unique place in Asari culture. Justicars are from another era. Young Asari grow up watching vids about our adventures. Pure fiction, of course. Some Asari are uncomfortable with us, but so few Justicars exist that most have never met one.
This outfit is a lot better on her. Justicars are rare, huh?
There are only a few Justicars?
Few Asari wish to make the sacrifices necessary to become one of us, and the training has a high casualty rate. It is a life of constant danger. Throughout the entire galaxy, there are only a handful of us at any time.
That sounds terrible.
Why would anyone want to be a Justicar?
It is a deeply personal matter. Sometimes the most brutal path is the only honest one.
Conflicting opinions?
The Asari I've spoken to seem conflicted about Justicars.
In this age, people see shades of gray everywhere. The code of the Justicar is black and white. I might seem a hero to many, but I would kill all of them if I had to.
The code.
This code of the Justicar seems central to your life.
It is 5,000 sutras and covers every situation one can encounter. I have memorized every word. There is only the code.
Is the code flexible? I don't think it is.
Sometimes justice calls for mercy.
It does not exist to bring about spiritual enlightenment. Its purpose is to punish the wicked and protect the innocent.
How do you see Justicars?
What role do you think Justicars have in Asari society?
I would say that the closest human equivalent is a knight-errant in your medieval lore. Perhaps mixed with a bit of samurai.
Romance in the code?
Does the code forbid romantic involvement?
It does not. However, I would never be interested in such. That part of my life is well behind me.
I'm not gonna choose that, because I don't want to head down some path. Killing?
What does your code say about killing?
I am compelled to kill the wicked. If a Justicar is involved, peaceful solutions are long past.
Without remorse?
You make killing sound so casual.
I remember each being I have slain. They are always in my thoughts.
Knowledge of humans. Her knowledge of humans?
You know about knights-errant and samurai?
Oh yeah,
when I knew I must leave Asari space again, I studied the history and morals of new species. When I was a maiden wandering the galaxy, humans had not yet arrived.
What do you think about humans?
What did your studies tell you about us?
You are more individualistic than any other species I have encountered. If three humans are in a room, there will be six opinions. I like your species. I am curious to see what you will do.
We do all kinds of crap. Alright, thanks.
I should go.
I'm glad we spoke.
So am I. Dr. Chakwas never has anything new to say, so I'm gonna check on her this time.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Do you have a minute, Miranda?
Of course. I've been meaning to speak with you, in fact.
Oh? That's right, I haven't talked to her after her mission, loyalty mission. I thought I saw her whole butt there.
I wanted to apologize. I didn't fully believe you'd be up to the task, and it seems I was wrong. Frankly, based on what I've seen, I wish Cerberus had recruited you earlier.
Okay, it must be this color here, well, where I'm pointing towards over her outfit, because it looked like her butt cheeks were hanging out. I'm kind of between this. Cerberus is wrong.
I trust you, but I don't trust Cerberus. Your experiments cross the line.
All the time, yes. But I recall a Spectre who crossed a few lines while hunting down Saren and the Geth. And we'd be lucky to have you. Too many join us out of simple xenophobia. We need more people here for the right reasons.
Huh. Interesting. What about Jack?
What was Cerberus trying to prove by experimenting on children like Jack?
A mistake, no question. Not mine. And one that was corrected once we discovered the extent of the experiments being performed.
I saw your monsters.
I saw your bases years ago. You were using Rachni, Thorian creepers, even husks to make your own army.
The husks were already dead. The Thorian creatures were mindless, and the Rachni were abandoned once we understood their intelligence. We weren't breeding an army, we were breeding expendable shock troops for high-risk scenarios. How many soldiers died in Saren's attack on Eden Prime? How many would have lived if we'd had just a dozen Rachni soldiers on our side?
Why do you like Cerberus?
With your intelligence, you could have landed any job you wanted. Why choose this?
Because I still envy the time Morden spent with the Special Tasks Group, working with people as smart as he was. Cerberus never tells me that something is impossible. They give me my resources and say do it. And they've given you even more. A new life, a new ship, the elusive man's personal attention.
I don't really want the elusive man's personal attention. You sound unhappy.
What, you disapprove?
No. I'm just impressed. You're... Well, look at you. A spacer kid, educated with on-ship tutorials, no strong foundation for stability.
Okay, it was the side. Is that her skin?
And you've done more than I could. Despite everything my father did to make me perfect, you're the best humanity has to offer.
You always bring that up.
You always bring up your genetic tailoring. It really bothers you, doesn't it?
This is what I am, Shepard. I can't hide it. The intelligence, the looks, even the biotics. He paid for all of that. Every one of your accomplishments is due to your skill. The only things I can take credit for are my mistakes.
That's not true.
You're not coasting on good genes, Miranda. Your ability and your dedication speak for themselves.
Thank you, Commander. I appreciate that. I should get back to work, but thank you for coming by.
Okay. Yeah, I feel like I'm dodging romance options all over the place here. Think I'm doing a good job so far? I want to inadvertently make people think I'm interested in them. Because they all seem to be available one way or the other.
Shepard, need me for something?
Have you got a minute?
Sure, just killing time anyway. Optimizing weapons charges, planning attack vectors, you know, relaxing. I'm still trying to figure out how to prepare for this mission. Humans don't deal with stress the way Turians do.
Yeah, I remember this option. And I remember asking him these. Ilos?
I thought you'd be used to high-risk operations on human ships. I mean, think about trekking Saren to Ilos.
Sure, but that was quick. We raced out, landed, blew up some Geth, and saved the galaxy. This time we've got Miranda and Cerberus and that AI all telling us what we're up against. I think I preferred blind optimism.
Yeah, the game... The first, game was a lot more... light, you know. I wouldn't say light-hearted, but this game's a lot darker. This story's a lot darker.
Thanks for the talk, Garrus. I'll see you later.
Sure thing.
Sure enough. Okay, let's head down to engineering. Where Tali hangs out now. Check in on Zaid.
Back for another lesson.
lesson?
I used to do a little scorched earth work here and there. Then the Batarians started muscling in. No one's as good with terror tactics as they are. I mean, yeah. The Krogans will come at you, break your face, kill your family. But the Batarians, they'll turn your planet into a glass parking lot without a second thought.
Yeah, I've heard they're really nasty.
Trying to remember, what was his name? Salarian infiltration specialist. 100-story man. Guy could disable a station security with a few taps on an Omni tool.
Huh.
He went to work with Eclipse a few years back. Had to kill him for a job. Your Morden Solus kind of reminds me of him.
Yeah?
I should let you go. Talk more later, Shepard.
All these doors opening. Automatically. What is this? Oh, right, right. Grunts over here.
Have time now, Shepard. I need to deal with this.
I don't have a lot of time right now. Can we do this later?
That is your decision. But don't wait too long, Shepard. I feel dangerous.
Yep. Dangerous.
Did you hear that we are sharing our deck with a Krogan?
Well, ain't that peachy?
They never say anything different. I don't think Jack's gonna say anything different. I'm not sure where Tali is in this area, but...
I need to get to Pragya, Shepard. Soon.
I'll think about that. Meanwhile, I have to go.
Yep.
Yep. Oh, she must be... by the core, the warp core, or whatever. Down here. Oh. I thought down there, but she's actually here. Hey, Tali.
Shepard, what can I do for you?
Like I scared her. How's your work going?
Is the new Normandy giving you any trouble?
Please, Shepard, I'm a Quarian. Give me a chunk of scrap metal, a circuit board, and some Element Zero, and I'll have it making precision jumps. Yeah. I was worried about working with Cerberus engineers, but they know what they're doing, and they've been very polite.
Yeah, those two are pretty cool. What's the status of the Normandy?
How's the Normandy running?
Say what you will about Cerberus. They know how to build ships. The Normandy's running even better than before. I don't know if it can stand up to a Collector attack, though. I'm researching some ideas that might help.
Yeah. Running better than before is because it's not the same Normandy. Any upgrades?
Can you do anything to give the Normandy an edge over a Collector ship?
Definitely. With the right supplies, I can fortify our shields. The Collectors cut through the Normandy's barriers immediately last time. My upgrades might give us a better chance.
Cool. Multi-core shielding. The rapidly oscillating kinetic obstructions of cyclonic barrier technology, CBT, are added to the ship. This should help the ship survive blasts like those that destroyed the first Normandy. That'll be a good thing.
Shepard, what can I do for you?
It's like she's like whirling around like I scared her. Any more upgrades?
Can you do anything to give the Normandy an edge over a Collector ship?
My shield fortification will help, but I don't think there is much more I can do.
Okay. I want to talk about you.
Have you got time to talk?
We didn't really have time to chat while taking out Geth on Haystrom, did we? I can't believe so many people died. Thank you again for getting Rieger out alive. All for data about stars blowing up. I hope the Admiralty Board gets some use out of it.
How's Rieger?
Have you heard any word about Cal Rieger? Did he survive his injuries?
He sent me a message. It looks like he'll make a full recovery. Anytime you get a suit puncture, it's a matter of luck. Rieger got out with a relatively minor infection.
Tell me about the Admiralty Board.
Tell me about the fleet's Admiralty Board.
It's one of two major political powers among my people. The admirals make decisions related to defense or needing immediate action. They also handle major criminal charges, like treason. The other political power is the Conclave, a group of representatives from each ship. They make most of our laws and fleet decisions.
Now you can really see, you know, I've said this before, back in the beginning of the series. You can see a lot more of her face than ever before. Response to data? I guess the Admiralty Board's response to data?
Any news yet on the data you sent?
I'm not likely to hear anything for a while. Or on an unsecured channel, for that matter.
So how are you doing?
Having any trouble settling back in on the Normandy?
I like the quiet. I miss the old faces, though. Presley, Engineer Adams, all
poor,
of them.
Poor Presley.
Doesn't seem right having Cerberus in charge of this ship. Are you sure working for them is the right thing to do?
I'm the one in charge.
Does it look like they're pulling the strings, Tali? I'm not working for them. They're working for me.
So you ordered the listening devices and tracking beacons that are all over this ship. I know you need resources to fight the collectors, but be careful, Shepard.
I didn't order that. Why do you hate Cerberus? That's a stupid question, but I'll ask it.
I caught some tension back on Freedom's Progress and again when you first came aboard. What happened between Cerberus and the Quarians?
They attacked one of our ships, the Idena. It seems they were attempting to kill or control a young human biotic who was on the fleet. I don't really know the details. I do know that Cerberus made an enemy of the Quarian people.
Well, I don't trust them.
I fully expect them to betray us at some point, and we'll be ready.
I'm glad to hear that, Shepard. Just let me know how I can help. For now, I should get back to work. Thanks for coming by.
Cool. Yeah, so we are done then. We have talked to all the crew. Right, so gonna end it off here. I'm not sure what I'm doing next. But, yeah, we definitely have a lot more places to explore. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.